First thing you'll need is the pacifier, some magnets, wipes, scissors, and clear silicone to get you started. Hello, everyone. So one of the videos that I keep getting asked for is how do I make my pacifiers? So I thought I would do a quick video today on how I do some of these full-sized pacifiers. So for example, this pacifier here has like a hole through it, but it's all one piece in silicone. And I turned it into this pacifier here. I also have this juvie pacifier, and you can see there's a big hole right here, and it comes through to a clear nipple, and I transformed it into this one. So there is a magnet here, and there is a piece here and some silicone there hiding, kind of masking the magnet. You still see the magnet because it is transparent, and unfortunately I haven't come up with a way unless I can find see-through magnets. I also have these Chico pacifiers, which I really like, but again, they have that hole here and then the nipple. And I've even modified these. So these are going to be the same way that I modify them, but there's just a tiny hole here that I've filled in. So I thought I would modify this blue one so that you can see what I do. So I'll take this, set the others aside for a moment. And then I'm going to show you some of the best practices, I guess, that I use. And the first is when I take pacifiers apart and take the little nipples off, I save these pieces. And I save them until they, you know, like the clear ones will start getting a little yellow. So I might, once those go, I'm just throw them out. But I'll save like the bigger bits and pieces because, as I've found, they do come in handy, especially when I made this pacifier. And you might ask me why, like what purpose could they ever serve? So the first thing is these holes here. You want to have a way to mask the magnet and kind of hold in the silicone that we're going to use. And so I use the tips of the pieces you cut off. So in, for example, in this one here, we've got this little tip. I had cut it off and used it on the back. I don't know if you can see that very well. And for this juvie, when you cut this nipple, you can see clearly, I wonder if I have the old juvie nipple in here. No, that's not it. You may have got rid of it or used it already, which is highly possible. But this, if I show you here, you can hopefully see that it is too small to use in the opening of this juvie passy. So what I ended up doing there is going to my stash, and I found one of the bigger ones like this here that are flat. And I just kind of cut it out like a big circle here so that this would cover that entire opening and just barely fit in there like that. So that's why I highly recommend saving these when you want to modify pacifiers in the future. You may be able to use one of these to help hide a hole. So again, what I do, especially with the colored ones, is I cut the nipple and I use that piece to mask the hole. So one of the first things, obviously, that you have to do is cut the nipple. And what I've done in the past is, depending on your reborn's mouth, will determine where you cut. If you've got a mouth that's, you know, kind of open, that takes a magnet, but, you know, could almost take a modified pacifier, or does take a modified pacifier, but also has a magnet in there and you want to use it to secure the pacifier in their mouth, what I do is I start small and I make a cut, and then I just insert it into their mouth to see how far it goes. And what I like to do is have their lips hit this flat part here, this flat part. And so I just recommend testing it and then cutting it, testing it, cutting it, testing it, cutting it, till you get it to the right size that you want. But keep in mind, your first cut needs to be enough to fill this hole right here. Now for Emmy, I've done a couple different ways for her, depending on the pacifier. I'm sorry, I'm going to be losing my voice a little bit. So this one, I don't know if you can see very well, but this one has a little ridge, like it, the nipple comes out, protrudes a little bit. And this fits great in her mouth with that little excess. Now, on these pacifiers, these Chico pacifiers, having the little extra doesn't work for her. It has to be flush. So I already know on this pacifier how far, how deep I want to go. So I'm going to just cut this one now, since I already know. I'm going to try and squeeze it so that you can see a little better. There we go. Now, it's still a little bit raised, and I know for Emmy that doesn't work. So what I'm going to do is just go in and cut a little bit of the raised part off. Just trying to make it as flat as I can to that piece. And also, I don't want like jagged pieces. When you cut it, you can feel if there's a jagged piece. You know, a little bit of bumps is fine. But so there is the pacifier now cut. So then what I do from this point is pretty simple. Just have this one out here for comparison. I have my box of magnets. Now I like to keep different sizes. You could keep different sizes, different thickness, whatever works for you. You can see I'm running low on some, so I'm going to have to do some ordering. I do have links to the, or a link to the Apex magnets that I, where I purchase my magnets, and I'll leave those in the description, or that one link. But I do have all of these various sizes right now, and they're different sizes, different thickness, and they even have different pull force. I typically like to really try and find a really strong pull force, because that's, you know, obviously what's going to hold the magnet to the magnet inside the vinyl. But the different sizes and thickness really help when you're trying to determine what is best for the pacifier. For example, I really like these big magnets on like a Nook pacifier, but they just simply don't work for this. I mean, they're not going to fit. So in this one, let me just double check. I think I used these. So, whoop, I did. Well, that's not why, but I can tell by the size when it matched up. So what I like to do is I kind of just take the magnets and fit it to say, okay, you know, is this magnet going to really fit there? Is it going to, you know, be kind of secure once it's done, and yet not try and take up or change the shape of the pacifier once it's in this little area. So these ones work well. I'm going to look at these ones because I have a lot of these magnets. Now, they don't have the strongest pull force, unfortunately. That's the only thing. So sometimes I would have to use quite a bit. And you can see here, that is just, it's kind of too small almost. So I'm not going to use these ones. I'll probably use these more for Emmy's bows with her magnet on her head. So, because I do have a ton of them. Now this is another one. Whoop! The dangers of having all your magnets together. Well, that's just not... I'm just going to do this. There we go. So this is another size that I have. And I've got like hot glue and... Yeah, just ignore that. But this is another size. And I use it quite a bit. And you can see here, it would work. There's no problem with that. So this has one size, and this could be a different size. Now with this, you know, sometimes I use one or two magnets when I do these type of projects. I think like this one, all these are the thinner ones that are in here, like this first pile here. And if I look, I think I've got three or four magnets in that because I wanted it to be really thick and have really help with the strength of the magnet. But I think I'm going to use this size. I'll have to get more. And I'm going to use two. So first I'm going to stick these on the existing pacifier. Close this so that my other magnets don't try to escape. Excuse me. So the next thing that I'm going to do is prepare the nipple for the hole here. And what you can do is just, you know, stick it there to see comparison how much you think you need to cut off just to cover it. It doesn't have to stick in this hole, just needs to cover it. You can stick it in if you have, like if it's a big enough hole. I've done that before. But typically I just like to cover it. Like here, you can see I've cut it and I'm just setting it there for size. So that sticks out a fair amount. So, and it covers, but the big thing is, does it cover that hole? Right? And when I'm looking through, I can see that this covers that big hole entirely. In fact, so much so, I might be able to make it a little smaller if I wanted. And I'm only doing two magnets, so it doesn't have to be that deep. I don't know if you can see, but that's another thing to check for, is how deep you need it to cover the magnets that you're adding. So I could probably trim this a little. Okay, so now I'm just going to check the magnets. Yeah, it still works. I'm going to check back here. Yeah, it still covers and is okay. This is a little weird right here though. It's kind of making it stick out. So now I have got these pieces together. Something I've noticed is sometimes on the nipple, there's a curved edge and a flat edge. And when you put it here, do you put the curved edge down, the flat edge down? What do you do? Well, it's totally up to you, however you like it. But just make note of that when before you actually go to the next step, just so you know what way you want it to fit in this hole. If you want a curved edge down, curved edge up, or if it really doesn't matter. And to me, on these ones, it really doesn't matter. So the next thing I'm going to do is set aside all this and get out my glue. Now, this isn't really glue, obviously. This is Loctite clear silicone. It's waterproof sealant, but Loctite is really good. It doesn't shrink, and that's a big thing. Some silicones will shrink, and that means that this it will easily pull off these silicone pacifiers, and it won't hold the magnet into the pacifier. So I personally recommend the Loctite. So I'm going to use that. And this is the silicone. I only use it on these silicone type pacifiers. You know, on my nooks when I take the nipple off and I'm just dealing with the plastic, all I do is use like E6000. But this is what I use for sealing bottles. And this is what I also use for my silicone pacifiers. So the first thing I do is I've got my Loctite glue and I'm going to fill this little part. If the silicone will come out. I cracked the top here. And I tried to fix it with silicone, but still the top part always seems to harden. So I always have an issue there. So I just use my little nail tool to fix that. Okay, so let's try this again. And it's still not gonna work. All right, so all I do is I just fill it with some silicone. And that's pretty much it. I just fill it enough that it's full of silicone. I set it aside for a moment here. And I take my magnets. So now that I know they're on this pacifier, I know how they go in. So this back end, I want in the nipple, this front end sticking out. So I'm going to put them in here. And this is, to me, this is a part that gets messy because the magnet is going to want to slide around a lot. The silicone pops out all over the place. You just got to work it till you're comfortable and have a paper towel handy or some wet wipes. Those really help with silicone. Okay, so it's in there. So what I'm going to do now is just slide it into position in the nip, in the pacifier. And the magnet, no, undoubtedly will move again. So just make sure it's covered and move it and covered and move it. So you can see it's not sticking through. If you want it to stick through, you can make it do that, but I don't. Now, as a final step, just to make sure it all seals together and there's coverage on the pacifier, I'm going to put some more silicone here. And then I use my finger just to kind of smooth it, make sure it's where I want it. Make sure the magnet stays where I want it to stay. Okay. Might want to put more silicone in there if you need to. I didn't have enough. And moving the magnet around quite a bit had the silicone all over my fingers instead of where it needed to be. So if we look in here, it is in, on there now. You might, if you find you've got a lot of silicone in here, like it leaked out or something, you do want to wipe it up or otherwise you'll see it. So I just take a wet wipe and I'm really careful to just really softly kind of clean that up. So I'll show you if I can find a wet wipe. Usually I have like a big case of them right here, but clearly I've run out and moved it. So I've got these water wipes too. I will grab one. Just a wet paper towel even works with silicone. So this is the pacifier that we made, and I'm just going to clean it a bit, make sure I didn't get silicone in places I didn't want it to be. And when you're doing this, really be careful not to move the piece or squeeze the piece. If you squeeze it like this, this little piece is going to pop off like I did. So you really need to be careful when you do that because it's not set. And I see the magnet moving. So I got to do all this again. And on this one, I cut the little nipple too far. I would have been better to leave it a little bigger because it's really having a tough time keeping those magnets in. And again, I also use bigger magnets than I used here. So that's another thing. The rounder, the bigger the magnet, you know, it's going to push more against the silicone of the nipple. So now if you have this, you've done it this way, I really recommend having a way to hang your pacifier like this. One, because we didn't put the magnet on the other side and the magnet's big enough that it's not going to fall through, but we want to make sure that gravity is keeping this magnet and this little piece down. So I usually find something just to hang it on that obviously is not magnetic, otherwise it'll attract your magnet and pull it out and ruin it. But yeah, I just find a place, let it hang like this to dry, and leave it for about 24 hours, and it should be good. So hopefully you found this video helpful. If you want any more videos on different pacifiers or anything, just let me know. Leave a comment in the comment section. Thanks for watching.